Mes amis, and welcome to the Rendezvous de Cajun radio and TV show live from the historic Liberty Theater in downtown Eunice, Louisiana. My name is Angèle Bellard, and I am a park ranger from the Jean Lafitte National Historical Park and Preserves Prairie Acadian Cultural Center, which is located right next door to this Liberty Theater. We, along with the City of Eunice, the St. Landry Parish Tourist Commission, the Cajun French Music Association, John Guillory Allstate Insurance of Eunice, and the Best Stop Supermarket are all proud sponsors of this show, which is truly a unique family experience and the only one of its kind. We are in for a good show this evening with Ray Landry as your MC and Jamie Burza and Cajun Tradition providing your music. I hope that you all enjoy the show. So now, if you will all please join me in giving a very warm welcome again to our first band this evening, Jamie Burza and Cajun Tradition.
Cajun Tradition Band, yes, sir. Ooh, this thing's hot. All the way to my left over there, a guy from my neck of the woods in Caracol, Mr. Pokey Guidry on bass back there. A guy no stranger to a microphone and no stranger to a guitar. I've been listening to him play for a long, long time. He plays in, probably started playing music up in Bro Bridge back up, at the time it was Mulage, at the time. It's Joe Mitsimo on vocals and guitar right there. Of course, this guy right behind me, right here to my left, it's a guy who came all the way from New York to play here tonight. I'm just joking, but a very good friend of mine. They enjoy his fiddle playing. He's a teacher of fiddle. Actually, he teaches just about every instrument there is. Mr. Henry Hample right here. Of course, we know the matriarch of the whole band, and I'm talking about Madeline on the drums back there, Madeline Burzas. And of course, on the accordion and vocals, Mr. Jamie Burzas, right there. I was trying to think a while ago, you and I go as far back as the Main Street.
Yes, sir.
I'm thinking that's where you and I first started playing music together, way back in the day. And I needed to tell you when I was thinking about that a while ago, is that he had Lee Manuel playing with you at one time. Mm-hmm. In fact, I wrote that song together, him and I, he wrote the song while mm-hmm. he was playing for a Cajun Tradition, Cajun band. And then, of course, if you know anything about Lee Manuel, he was playing with Nokale Young as well when I was playing with Nokale Young. And do you know that we inducted Lee Manuel into the CFMA, right down the road, Hall of Fame this year?
This year?
This year. He should have been there a long, long time ago, but he made it finally this year. So
Hey.
Okay, we're going to do La Voix du Couillon.
Yep.
La Voix du Couillon. The Crazy Walls. Is that your fan club right there on the second row? Is that your family right there?
Yeah.
Tell them guys hi.
That's my sister and her son and daughter-in-law, grandkids, and her husband, Kurt. And my mom's here somewhere hiding. I don't know.
There she is.
She likes to hide room. In the darks.
Well, welcome. Welcome. It's a potential Cajun musicians I see on the second row there.
Never know.
Allons à Lafayette. Let's go to Lafayette tonight, okay? Thank you. Lafayette. Joe, come right to that microphone. You know, on va parler moto un petit peu.
Mon courrier m'a venu.
So, I guess the first time I ever saw you was at New Lots at the time, and you were playing with...
Let's see, I played there with Jamie, I played there with Mr. Don Montesay for some time, kind of off and on with Philae a little bit once in a while.
You were really busy back in the day, and you know, I try to tell everybody about, especially some of the younger kids, like I have some younger kids, and I tell them, I say, when I go to some of these places and I tell them, and you know, and they'll see so many people there dancing, and I'll say, you know, I remember in the day, the only place you could ever come here, the only place you could dance actually, was in between the chairs at the table.
Pretty much.
And the places like that, 24/7, 7 days a week.
On Sundays when Philae would play, you couldn't hardly move in there. They had so many people.
That's exactly right. Yes. Yeah. Yes. Wonderful, wonderful experiences. That I had at a place like it. Today it's called Pombrose. Back in the day, it was called Mulots.
That's correct.
Did you get a chance to play with Octa Clark and those guys there?
Yes, I played with Mark Boudreau. Actually, took Mr. Octa's place when he kind of retired. He played, I think, like 13 years there.
Yeah,
pretty regular.
And but I'm talking about bands like Doug Balfa and Octa Clark and Hector Dujon and the guys and Philae and Ward Lorman and you and all those guys back in the day. It was the reason. Back in the day that place was so successful. And listen, when I tell you it was all traditional Cajun music, it was.
Pretty much.
All traditional Cajun music.
Pretty much.
So, La Bouteille.
Yes, sir, Miss Cheryl Combier.
Tu sais qui va chanter ça, toi, Cheryl?
Oui.
J'étais avec le reine aujourd'hui.
Je vais essayer.
She was at the jam session today. She's probably listening. She said she was going to listen. So
well, if Cheryl, she is, I want to dedicate that to her.
Oh, good.
C'est mon idée.
You know, I never get a list. I never get a list of that many songs. I got to tell you. So,
you're welcome. You're welcome.
Thanks for that. Yeah, you're sure. So we're gonna go ahead and jump into. On va jouer l'autre chanson, le petit galop pour le pain tout pain.
La bande de la bleue mignonne, de la bleue jolie, mais dans les yeux canards. Des pains d'un bap que ça goûtait dans le bec, et des pains d'un bap que ça veut pas venter. Petit galop, mais pour la pointe au pain, petit galop, mais pour la pointe au pain. Chat joli, mais dans les mots de larmes, mais si c'est pas de larmes, ça vaut pas du tout. Jolie, mais t'as les yeux canards. Des pains de map que ça goûtait dans le bec. Et des pains de map que ça veut pas porter. Petit galop, mais pour la pointe au pain. Petit galop, mais pour la pointe au pain. Chat joli, mais dans les mots de larmes. Mais si c'est pas de larmes, ça veut pas du tout.
Joe, that big tablet in the front of you, is that all the songs you know? You know more than that?
I got a page. I got about, I don't know, I guess about 120 or 30 in there.
Wow.
Wrote down, and I have a few more somewheres in the memory recall that don't work like it used to.
Joe's the kind of guy you want playing behind you with the recording, but he knows every song out there. Pokey, come by that microphone just for a second.
Yes, sir.
You know, it's something that whatever. This is David Guidry, Pokey Guidry, to all his friends. And if
yes,
by all means.
Thank you.
If anything would happen to Pokey, like win the lottery or something, and somebody would come up to you and say, "Man, you heard about David Guidry?" Then everybody would say, "Who?"
Who?
Because nobody knows him by David. Everybody knows him by Pokey.
Yes, sir.
Actually, I've been knowing him almost all my adult life.
Just about. Just about.
And then actually, his sister used to work for me. Sandra,
that's right.
Used to work for me back in the day when I first started construction work, and she's doing okay. She was a real good carpenter.
Oh,
yeah.
Yeah, she's retired now, and she's traveling the world.
Really? Well, good for her. She always wanted to do
that. She enjoys herself.
Talking about music, you had a chance to play with Aldous Roger at one time, but you were playing with
I didn't have a chance. I did.
Okay, I did. You had the chance and you took it.
Oh, my God, yes, and yes. It was enjoyable.
Yeah, so how many years you played with him?
I just played 1 year. It's when he came out of retirement. He still had some time left, and he wanted to play. So Mr. Don Guillory got me with him.
Okay.
And I took advantage of that.
At the time, Don Guillory was on drums and...
He was playing, yeah, let's see. No, Gerald was playing drums.
Yes.
And well, Don was on guitar.
I remember when he came out, and you were probably with him, for a big old dance on Main Street in Lafayette.
Yeah, I think so.
Somewhere about Pontiac Point when they saw.
Yep.
Who else did you play with back in the day?
Back in the day, started out with Belton Richard, 8 years. We did the album together. Belton at his best. And it was fun doing the album. It was great. We got to doing it at a historical site in Crowley, which is now a museum.
Okay.
The recording studio is a museum. Historical place now. I got to hand it to the millers up there, man. They're making it go.
They got to pay you some royalties.
Yeah, they should. They should. But, you know, life goes on, and it's wonderful, sure. Ray. It's more an honor.
Sure.
It's more an honor. And then I play with Mr. Walter Mouton and, of course, Cheryl Cormier, too.
Yeah, she did say that.
Yes, yes. It was an honor, man.
You know, and it's like we were talking a while ago when Jamie and I were talking. We were just on a te gâté. We didn't realize what we had in front of us. We just like Cajun music. So
yep.
It got to where we were just taking that stuff for granted and listening to Aldous and listening to the Balfour Brothers and listening to everybody at the Main Street. So somebody's about ready to throw something at me because we've been talking too long. My friend David Guidry over there.
Mr. Ray Landry, yo.
Timoris. Timoris, did you ever get a chance to go there?
No.
Well, I did. back in the day, you know, those places, like the Woody Woodpecker Club was back off of Beaubas Saint Road way back then. We went there. If my daddy would have known half of the places I was going to, he would have given me more whippings than he gave me. So it was all out of love, I'm pretty sure, but it didn't feel that way. The next song that Jamie and I'm going to play is probably a favorite song of a young accordion player if he enters an accordion contest. It's called a Crawley Two-Step. And I don't know if he does it, maybe not, but there's a chance to modulate in that song as well on the Crawley Two-Step. So it's a favorite of the young musicians to try to impress the judges at an accordion contest. So Jamie and I'm going to do that for you right now. Something called the Crawley Two-Step. Deux pas de Crawley. This song is probably one of the most beautiful songs in Cajun music, recent waltzes, and I'm not talking about going way back and listening to some of the waltzes by Ira Lejeune and Walter Muto and all those guys back there, but this guy, Pierre von Mondego, almost wrote all the songs, but he did write all the songs for Paul Daigle and sung by Robert Elkins. This next song, La Lumière dans ton châssis, The Light in the Window.
Beautiful song.
c'était pour moi la lumière de ton châssis. Pour la voyer, c'était ainsi que toi t'étais seul. Ton mari n'était pas là, toi tu m'espérais. J'allais te joindre, petite fille, et mon cœur dansait content. Mon scrognet était la seule, puis mon cœur roulait.
See, beautiful song. Well done, by the way, Joe. For some of us who consider themselves vocalists, sometimes when you listen to a radio, you listen to a certain artist, like this next song. It comes to mind because the first time I heard it, I said, man, I love that song. So I learned how to play it. And it just happened to be when I was playing a D accordion. It looks like I would have had a little bit more sense than to try a song like the High Point Two-Step in D at the time. And so, but I said, you know, I could do it. So the next time Nogali and I played, I think we was at Belly's there, and I cranked up on the High Point Two-Step And all of a sudden I realized I just couldn't do it. I couldn't get in that octave, to sing it. Have you ever been in that position, Joe? I'm pretty sure, no. Every singer has been in that position where they listen to a song on the radio and they say, oh man, I'm gonna go home and I'm gonna learn that song and I'm gonna sing it. But when you get behind that microphone, you sure change your mind in a hurry. Happened to you?
Yeah.
Yeah.
When the accordions first came here, pretty much, the German people brought the fiddle, but the accordion.
Yeah, sure. Yes.
They were mostly sea accordions.
Yes.
And then when they started locally people building accordions, they started making a B flat. And a lot of those old timers said, man, I like that sound of that B flat because they could sing behind it.
Yeah, it's much easier for me to do that. Well, I remember that song, the High Point Two Step, because the first time I played it, I couldn't sing it. So we're going to do it for you, something called the High Point Two Step. You can imagine I was in a bind back in that day when I, because that was done in C, actually with a C accordion, and then I had a D accordion, which is about 40 octaves higher than that. You know, if you have a young man, actually don't have to be that young, and you're looking for an instructor, a musical instructor for just about any instrument on the bandstand, that's the band to see, Henry Hample, right there. That's what he does. Saifé Point V. Yeah. He's originally from New York, had an opportunity to play with Jesse Leger back when Jesse moved to New York and did a couple of years there. And then he came to Louisiana, one of the festivals, and après ça, c'était foutu. Il est tombé dans l'amour avec un petit cajun, après ça, c'était foutu. He got married here and decided to play music here. And this, we have been blessed to have Henry Hempel as part of our Cajun culture. And he's an excellent instructor. And under his belt, he has hundreds and hundreds of kids that he has taught Cajun music to. And listen, we have had some serious discussions. Henry knows about every kind of genre of music out there. And so this is the guy you need to talk to. La chemin, la petite chemin que t'as pris, the little road that you took. Is that the Gary Bros, Jimmy Bro, or UJ Moe back in the day? So that's the Bro Brothers from Bro Bridge made that song.
That was recorded on Jimmy's one of Jimmy's albums.
That's right. In fact, you know what I saw on Facebook today? I saw when the Ray Laverne was on drums and did vocals with UJ, and Jimmy was playing one of his first gigs. Mm-hmm. He already still looks like a little boy, but I could about imagine in the day he was
He's a little short guy.
Yeah. Leticia Rancatapri, the little road that you decided to take. You know, back in the day, UJ Moe was actually Jimmy Bro and Gary Bro's stepdad. And then if you're trying to remember who UJ Moe is, he was a fiddle player for Walter Mouton for years and years and years. And sadly, we missed him some years back where he passed away, but still remembered through all his songs and his music for sure. And notre chanson que tu fais par Pierre Vomandego, La Petite Robe Courte, The Little Short Dress. Thank you. like that me.
Gloria.
We got a lot of songs to catch up. Mon cœur fait plus mal. Is that, is it my heart hurts no more, or it hurts more?
Don't hurt no more.
Don't hurt no more.
My heart don't hurt no more, okay?
Nathan Abshar.
Nathan Abshar.
Yes.
Can't go wrong there, buddy. And then at Fred's in Mamou.
Yes, once a month.
Once a month.
At Fred's, except in hunting season.
Oh, yeah. Asked a while ago, I said, you must be from Ville Platte. He said, no, I'm from Mamou. Understood.
Let's get it straight, yeah.
The Scott Playboy, the guy we were talking about a while ago, UJ Moe, was on this original cut for this song here with Walter Mouton and the Scott Playboys, and that's the name of that song. Something called a Scott Playboy Special. Okay. We gotta make sure everybody's on the same page. God play more special. You listen to the great music of Jamie Burzas and Cajun tradition over there with Madeline, his wife, on drums. And of course, Henry Hempel, Joe Simon, and David Guidry on bass back there. And they are the Cajun tradition, Cajun band. So, J'ai fait mon idée. Is that an Adam Aber song? J'ai fait mon idée. Is that
Shirley Bergeron?
That's right. That's right. You know.
Shirley and Al Fick.
Actually, Shirley actually was playing with Noncale Young right when he became ill. He was playing with us, and let me tell you, man. Back in the day, we had Shirley Bergeron and Joe Minier, Cabrillo on vocals, and sometimes Bobby Michaud.
Yeah.
Didn't get no better than that, Sean. We was in hog heaven and didn't realize it.
He was a great vocalist. No, sure. Great person, too, you know.
Yes, yes. J'ai fait mon idée, I made up my mind. Great song by Shirley Ray Bergeron. I know where I made the mistake a while ago, because Adam Hébert was actually the fiddle player for Alfie Bergeron and Shirley Ray Bergeron when they were called the Veteran Playboys. And then when they split years after that, well, Adam Hébert had the Country Playboys, and then Alfie Bergeron and them kept the Veteran Playboys. So I knew I wasn't far off, but.
Yeah.
Next song I'm going to do for you is something called the Back of Town Two-Step, a song that was actually recorded by Octa Clark way back in the day. Thank you. Yes, sir. The Back of Town Two Step. I'd like to send this next song out to my mother-in-law and my father-in-law listening, and they listen every Saturday up in Washington, Louisiana. Anna Joyce and Bozo Jones. He's got his ears right. Actually, he's going to wait for a week and watch it on TV. So I'd like to do this next song for them, something called La Charge Chari. The next song that Cajun tradition is going to play is something called La Chanson de Limonade, recorded actually by Leroy Broussard back in the day. You know, and Leroy also got inducted into the CFMA Hall of Fame this year. So thanks to those guys for sure. They're the reason we keep playing traditional Cajun music. So the next song is called La Chanson de Limonade, the Lemonade Song.
Yeah.
You know, I had an opportunity in my lifetime to meet some very, very fine Cajun musicians. It's amazing their writing ability. One of them was, of course, Dewey Bogfather, who was one of my favorites for sure. And then Adam Abey, actually, I had an interview with him for a couple of hours. And I asked them, I said, all the songs that you write, are they true life experiences? He said, well, most of the time. And both of them ended up being some traveling salesmen where they spend a whole lot of time on the road. Back in the day, they didn't have as much radio as it did, so they got the idea of the song while they were driving. Adam told me, he said he had to hurry up and come home while the tune was still fresh in his mind and write the lyrics down, and then he would add some music to it. And I'm saying that because the next song is J'aimerais te pardonner. I'd love to forgive you, but I can't. So I'm pretty sure this is a true life experience. Qui c'est qu'a fait ça, tu connais?
Do it, Bafa.
One of my favorite for sure. I'd love to forgive you. J'aimerais te pardonner. J'aime les pas donner. I knew I liked it for some for a certain reason. We had a special request to do the Shamrock Two-Step. We're going to do that for you right now. Carrément, maintenant. Another great song that was recorded by the Balfour Brothers, La Voce du Grand Bois, The Big Wood Waltz. You gotta find it on there, huh, Joe? I'd have to look a lot further than that to sing that song, I tell you, buddy.
Santa's gonna bring me an iPad for Christmas.
I know what you mean.
I'm hoping anyway.
Thank you.
Yeah, we got enough time to do one other one. I want to thank Jamie Berzas on vocals and accordion right there, and also his wife Madeline on drums back there, Henry Hempel on fiddle, Joe Simo on vocals and guitars, and of course my buddy over there, Mr. Pokey Guidry on bass. And the last song we're gonna do is actually a medley, the Mamu Hot Step, Attrape Mon Chapeau, the Shupik Two-Step, and the Basco Stomp, all at one time. That's going to be amazing.
Yeah, it'll be fun. Yeah, we want to thank you for coming to do this with us, Ray. It was an honor to be with you here tonight.
Yeah, thank you.
We want to thank all the people for coming, and the dancers especially.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Yes.
Thank those people. They're responsible for keeping our culture alive.
That's it.
We're going to do that for you, and thanks for coming tonight. Y'all be careful on the way home, folks.